Hey there guys, Black Panther here, and welcome back to the crew, the Big D, the D, whatever you want to call it, the Mercedes 300S Alarm Bobber Doodah. We're going to be customizing it today. Well, we're not. We're going to be making it not street stock anymore. We're going to put a circuit kit on it. That's basically what we're going to do. So let's whack that on there, see how we do. Please put a big wing on it. Because remember, if you like it, I should have put a wing on it. And they fucking didn't tell you that. You know what? No. So there's no big wing on this thing at all. Look at that Ford GT looking fierce in the background. But that exhaust. Oh my god. What is that? And it's got like a little bit of glass at the front blocking the intake. What? So other than that, they've basically ruined it. They've put lights at the front, they've blocked out the intake at the front, and they've put some weird thing on the exhaust, which looks pretty cool, I gotta say. But like, remove the top of the car if you're gonna put the little shield. What? So they've changed the interior somewhat as well. You can see that it's more maroon and brown and woody. What we're gonna do is see if this thing launches just like its brother. Here we go! Oh my lord. It launches quicker. It wants to kill me multiple times. Okay. Now to see if this thing turns right. Okay, this is really weird. It's really, really loose. Let me increase the force feedback because that is not right at all. Let's see if that makes it a lot better. So it's a little bit, I've actually got a bit of weight in it now. We're in sport, so we should get a little bit of responsiveness, but a little bit of slide as well. And it's now, it's really light. Like, you don't have to be very aggressive with it. Let's see what it's like on a sharper corner. Come on, actually turn. Understeer! Understeer! That is awful! Oh my god! What is this? So again, we've got a car that's unlike any other in the fact it won't actually turn. Now we full throttle. So you gotta drive it like it is a granddad car. There goes an also granddad car that actually turns, and it's American. Hello, sir. Let me join you in actually learning to Oh, balls! I am so sorry. This is such a weird car, because if I normally, when you're full throttle, you can still turn properly, but no, if you change down, you can. My brain is not working with this car today. Slow down a little bit. Brake, 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 brake. Thank you. Go a little bit quicker through this corner. Change up a gear. There we go. So it's a bit different to drive. In the fact that, well, it. What is this? I mean, normally when cars feel different, that's a good thing because they should do. But this thing is just understeering, and the steering is really, really light in itself. Like, that was full lock for a second there. That was full lock again. That's more understandable. When I'm going a decent pace, nah, it doesn't know that exists, mate. Look, what is that? That is awful understeer. Jesus Christ, and then it just bounces everywhere. Mate, this is supposed to be lowered at circuit. Understeer, 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 understeer. That was gear one. Gear two, brake. Drive. Yes, there you go. You got that one right. Let's try hardcore. So we should get a bit more of slide, meaning we should be able to take the corners better. There we go. So it seems to be a car that you've got to master more so in hardcore to actually get anywhere with. It's quite an interesting way of going about it, I guess. It's turning a lot more in this mode, and it's a lot more responsive, and it felt really light and floaty a second ago, and now it feels like it responds to everything as it should. It still feels old in its response, if that makes sense, but I don't know. Come on. What the bloody balls? Yes. You pleb. What are you doing, you pleb? Fuck off. Trying to drive me granddad car here. You're going the wrong way, you stupid. What the freaking hell was this bouncing? Okay, take another corner. Spin it. No. Come on, Merc. Take this corner right. Can't full throttle it. Can't full throttle it. Can't full lock it. I'm fucking dead. I just crashed me. Oh, bloody hell.
Hello, LaFerrari. Pleb.
How is all the posh people drive Mercedes? A fucking move off the road. Oh, balls. Okay, I think I've figured out why it's acting weird. When you start to turn it too much, it bounces. And then it just bounces and you lose front traction. And then it's just like, oh, fuck it, I give up. It's weird. I don't get it. Bouncing, 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 bouncing. Please stop bouncing so I can drive. To me, compared to every other car in the game, it feels way too floaty and it doesn't turn very well unless you're going very, very slow. I say that 120 miles an hour isn't very slow, but in racing games, especially an arcade racing game, 120 is very fucking slow. For when they usually reach about two something, you know, 200. But if you've driven this car, make sure to let me know your thoughts on it down below. Are your thoughts the same? Does it feel a bit weird to you? Or is it your favorite car now? I mean, in sport, it seems to just understeer. So if you could control that understeer, you might get somewhere without fucking bouncing and dying. But until next time, guys, I will see you once I actually get back on the road. Bouncing again! In the next video, be sure to hit like if you enjoy and subscribe if you're new for more racing game content. But until next time, guys, I'll see y'all soon when I can actually turn. Peace.